What's up, Baltimore? It's your boy, Nick Burr. And with it being National Travel and Tourism Week, the No Pics After Dark podcast with my guy, Aaron Dante, will be doing a four-part special series sponsored by Visit Baltimore. So get ready, turn up your volumes, because you'll hear all about the power of travel with Baltimore's hospitality community and how they all came together to create a great experience for visitors, whether you're from out of state or right around the corner. So welcome to Baltimore. Ayo, Aaron, talk to him.
Welcome to the No Pics After Dark podcast. I'm your host, Aaron Dante. I'm so excited to have these next guests on. I went to their place to go eat some food. Let me tell you something. I ate that food. I went back for seconds. I said, spend my whole damn paycheck, you know? So I appreciate what they're doing out here. They are a Black-owned business in Baltimore. So without further ado, we're not going to, this is their show. Chef Q and Dedric from Creole Soul. How are you guys doing today?
What's up, everybody? Good.
Hi, Aaron. Hi, everyone. Thank you for having us.
Oh, this is going to be exciting. This is going to be a great episode. I'm so excited to have you on. I mean, you guys are busy. So I'm happy you guys gave me about 20 minutes of your time. I really appreciate it. I really do. So tell the audience about you and like how you guys opened up the restaurant in Baltimore. Talk to us a little bit about you.
Okay, so I'm Chef Q, this is Dedric, and we are the owners, operators of Creole Soul Restaurant located here in Baltimore, Maryland. We are actually a Black-owned, veteran-owned business as well. So Dedric and I both served in the military while I'm still active duty. He served 24 years, retired in 2017. I actually retired this year in June or July 2021, so I'm very excited about that. We came about, we had this concept of cooking or starting the restaurant because our family, we come from a long lineage of cooks and just, you know, heritage of, you know, family and friendship and counsel and of course God. So we decided that, you know, hey, what are we going to do once we retire, once we hang up our hats from the military? And, you know, Dedric and the kids got together and said, hey, you know, we should open a restaurant. And I'm like, no, I just like cooking for the fun of it and seeing people laugh and stuff. But we tried our hand back in 2018 as a pop-up at our house located in the Remington area of Baltimore. And then it has just been going ever since. But the reason why we, the background of it is that I'm from Atlanta. Dedric was born in Baltimore, but he was actually raised in North Carolina. And then I also have family that comes from Louisiana, New Orleans, Louisiana. And so we just decided to put this concept together before the pop-up and say, okay, what would we call this place? And we took every aspect of our family and merged it into the name Creole Soul. And that's how we came up with the restaurant. And we had established the restaurant early on in 2018, and we have been in business ever since. We are just a good mixture of Creole, New Orleans Creole, and Georgia Southern, North Carolina Southern food that would just melt in your mouth like nobody's business. So, we really love family. We wanted a concept that will bring people back to the dinner table and just put our phones down and let's talk again, you know, over some good food, great counsel, and some jokes. So,
I love that. I love what you said at the end. You were like, you know, put your cell phones down, mm-hmm. enjoy each other, enjoy the moment,
right?
Being with each other. Right. That's missing, but, you know, and I like that you said that. I mean, folks, I'm going to tell you, I had a beignet there, maybe one, two, three, or four. I didn't want to share, so I already know I didn't want to share anything. Right. So it was delicious.
Right.
So this week we're talking about the power of travel for the National Travel and Tourism Week. Why is travel, even in around your own city or region, so important?
Well, travel is important because number one, like I said, we are in the military. You know, from day one, since we enlisted, we have been set sail on the waters of the Mediterranean, of the Asian waters of the Pacific and all of that stuff, right? So we've traveled many a places, and I cannot tell you how much culture and experience that I gained from all of those travels. And even with the travels with my culinary skills, I learned so much from the chefs over there, how to do certain things. So it was just really amazing. And it exposed a Georgia girl, you know, somebody who was just kind of confined to the walls of Atlanta, out in this big world that we have. Travel is really important because you get to meet new people, experience new things, and just learn about different cultures. I mean, imagine if you never, you know, went outside of Baltimore. You know, if I've never went outside of Atlanta, Dedric never went outside of North Carolina, you know, how would that be? How well would we know the people that are among us, basically just outside of our own state? How would you know about beignets and the good food of New Orleans or Atlanta? How would you know about second line bands and things like that? You know, it's so many things that we can explore and learn from each other. I don't know, you know, hey, I don't know what a deep dish pizza tastes like in Chicago. You know, okay, well, I mean, they may not know what fried green tomatoes taste like in Atlanta, you know, in Georgia. So, and it goes just beyond food. The culture itself is just so important. The travel to get to know people, to see God's wonders of the world. I can't stress that enough. So.
And that's what Baltimore is. Baltimore is a seventh wonder of the world.
It is,
especially with the Maryland blue crab. And Baltimore being a seafood city as well. And Baltimore is the greatest city in America. It's all on the bus benches you see at every bus stop. So, you know, why Baltimore is a place you need to visit is, like Chef was saying, it was because of the culture. You know,
because of the culture,
and we do it for the culture,
the love of the people.
I always tell my friends, and it's always a big debate right now with DC and Baltimore with the better food and whatnot, and I say, you want to go get some good seafood, come to Baltimore.
Yes.
You know, come to Baltimore, we got the best crabs. I mean, you know, it's just the seafood and the gumbo. You got the gumbo y'all have.
Yes.
See, I'm getting hungry right now. I know people watching and listening, like, we got to go over there right now and find out what this is all about. So I love how you guys talk about Baltimore and the blends of North Carolina, you know, Georgia, you guys, you know, just blending that all in. I love hearing that. So how did you work together with the community to get through this time, like during the pandemic? Like, what did you guys do?
Oh man, that was really tough for everybody. You know, we just really just kind of got close, and Dedric can attest to this more. When the pandemic hit, you know, fortunately to say for us, we were not in a position that so many others were. Like I said, I'm still active duty, Dedric's retired. So there was some type of income coming in for us to sustain in our personal lives. That was not the case for our employees. So we did make sure that we reached out, make sure that we offer assistance to our employees first. You know, we know we can't save everybody, but the ones that we're closely connected to, we're gonna always make sure that we have a hand in helping out when we can. But we have got with community leaders, and we've done a few events to feed the homeless and the low income communities. And just offered our services, whatever we could do at the time. I know that it was not much. You know, we had to practice, you know, do safe practices because of COVID. And, you know, a lot of times people are kind of like, you know, standoffish with, you know, putting themselves in a servitude situation when they can put their own safety at risk. But, you know, Dedric and I, we come from a background of military, and this is just what we're about. So it was really no question about it. We see a need, we feel a need because we love people, and we want to see, we know that we can't get through this thing without each other. So it was really difficult, but we saw how Baltimore just pulled together as a community, and it was just all love. And to know that, you know, people had resources from here and others had resources from there, and we kind of pulled together and we made this thing work and we pulled through. And it was just amazing. And so that was how kind of how we helped out and just offered our services, and we do it all over again if, you know, if something else were to
happen.
We still do it now, but we would, yeah, definitely, you know, jump in and go for what we know. So
all right, folks, we'll be right back after these messages.
Creole Soul, where New Orleans meets Southern hospitality. Founded by Chef Q and her fiancé Dedric in 2018, inspired by their family and loved ones from New Orleans, Atlanta, and Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Creole Soul, located inside our house in the Remington District, offers the best in authentic Creole and Southern cuisines that satisfies every taste bud. We strive to bring families back to the dinner table, so come eat at Creole Soul. Spice for your life and food for your soul.
Folks, we are back with Creole Soul, the owners of Creole Soul. Let me tell you something. Again, their food, outstanding. Outstanding. I mean, I've had the shrimp, fish, and grits. I'm just going to I'm going to leave it there, folks. If you ever had some Southern shrimp and grits, I took a nap after. That's how good it was. That was good, some good food. And everybody was outstanding service from the whole entire team, from the beginning to end. I didn't know what type of sauce to put in my beignet. They walked me through it. It was just a beautiful spot. And, you know, like I said, we're the owners, and they're, you know, it's amazing. So now that things are opening back up, hopefully,
right?
How are we getting people back into the restaurant? How are you guys doing it?
Oh, wow. You know, we've had a very steady customer base with our menu so far before the pandemic happened, and then basically kind of throughout, even through our delivery apps and everything. But now we are reinventing our menus. We are offering specials. We want to expand it a little bit more so, you know, people will come in and say, hey, okay, I've experienced what we had before everything happened, right? So now, okay, what specials that, you know, are they offering that they didn't have before? Like the white chocolate bread pudding, like jambalaya. The crawfish etouffee. So those things that we put out, people would just have to follow us and just, you know what that special is going to be for that weekend. And they can come on down and enjoy just some good, you know, some good customer service. Like you said, some good customer service, some new dishes, some new options. And also inside the R House, they are just opening the bar back up, which was a big thing for a lot of the restaurants. You know, they couldn't, you know, people couldn't come there and have a drink and, you know, just sit down and just have a relaxing time with a nice dinner, where our food is always a good pair with a, you know, with, you know, with a good, you know, adult beverage. So we have a drink at the bar, at the R bar, that's called the QT. And we paired that with our blackened salmon shrimp and grits, which went amazing. It was actually advertised on a news station, and it was great. It was really great. And so we just try to reinvent ourselves and try to, you know, get Baltimore to bring Baltimore into New Orleans, bring Baltimore into the South, to make sure that they're experiencing all the things that we grew up on. And that's on a weekly basis.
Okay. What have you learned about yourselves through this pandemic?
Ooh. Oh, so much. Wow. I learned family is very important. The sticking together, making sure that, you know, we support each other during these times. I even, you know, I had said before, without Dedric, and the kids, like I would have lost my mind. Split between the military and the restaurant and this pandemic, with all this pandemic stuff going on, it has just been crazy, crazy times. People are quarantined and they can't get outside the house. And we experienced a little bit of that as well. So it was just that learning piece of what familyhood was. We learned, we had a chance to learn about each other, things that we did not know.
And did not like.
You know, it forced us to kind of deal with those issues that we, that had been, you know, just kind of floating around, and we were just too busy to do that. So it made us stop in our tracks and really realize and focus how important family is, how important community is, how important our lives are, and you know, how grateful we are to God that we get to live this thing called life. You know, a lot of people did not make it through this pandemic, and we don't take any of that stuff for granted. So good health, you know, we thank God for good health. We thank God for, you know, the things that we probably taken for granted within our own family, and just to be a little bit more loving, a little bit more kind, a little bit more caring, because you truly don't know when your last day is going to be. So that's basically what we learn.
And another thing to add on top of that, you know, the African saying, it takes a village.
Absolutely.
So what we did, we partnered with community leaders. We got out there to have a community cohesiveness that's good for, you know, everybody, not only just in the restaurant game, but also with other entrepreneurs, African-American entrepreneurs. And we wanted to see how we could just help each other out, you know, in areas that they were lacking in. And if it was a financial support, that was good. If it was advertising on our own social media page, that was good. But I think really it takes a village, and it's the cohesiveness within our community that kept, you know, Baltimore alive, because we're still alive and kicking.
Oh, absolutely. It's been a wonderful experience, you know, just to see how we've kind of gotten back up every day. Like now we go outside and we see these folks that's just walking around, enjoying, you know, some ice cream, or just a walk in the park with the dogs or the kids and everything like that. And it's truly something that, again, we just cannot take this life for granted. Live it to the fullest. You know, whatever makes you happy, treat people with kindness, do good, you know, and make your community and this life just so much better than where you found it. So
I love that. Where can we find you? Your contact info. Are you guys on social media? Are you on Instagram, LinkedIn? Are you TikToking, Dedric? Are you TikToking right now, brother? I don't know. Are you out there dancing around doing the TikTok? Just where can we find you?
So look, you can find us on the World Wide Web, www.creolesoulrestaurant.com. You got social media, you got TikTok, you got Instagram, you got Facebook, and you got Twitter. We're even tweeting now. So
yeah, we're all on, and that's the ad is Creole Soul Restaurant. So for those who are out there that are searching for some really good, authentic New Orleans, Georgia, North Carolina, Southern food. So yeah, we can be found anywhere. And also come visit us, 301 West 29th Street, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211. That's located inside the R House in the Remington District.
And what are your hours? So we can make sure to plug your hours in.
Yes, our hours are, so we are closed on Monday and Tuesdays. We are open Wednesday through Sundays, Wednesday and Thursday from 12 to 8 p.m. And then Friday and Saturday, 12 to 9 p.m. And then on Sunday from 12 to 8 p.m.
Okay.
Yeah.
Y'all heard that, yeah, okay? Y'all heard that. I appreciate you two coming on the show.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm excited for the listeners, the viewers to hear this and see this. And you know how you talked about Baltimore and travel, and how it's really the power of travel. It's really a beautiful thing. I'm glad anybody comes around within 24 miles, 50 miles, go check them out. Mm-hmm. Hey, I might meet you there. Shoot me a DM. I might meet you there, have some more food. You know, I don't even care about weight loss anymore. I'm just going to eat and enjoy myself.
Oh, yeah.
I've already got the pandemic 15 on me already, so it's all right.
I mean, we're all struggling over here. It's okay. It's okay.
Any last words for the folks before we get off?
No, I just said, you know, thank you again, Aaron, for this opportunity. Thank you for to visit Baltimore. Thank you to all our family, our friends, our customers, all of our support team that has been out there supporting us for day one. We're making a vow that we're going to continue to serve you, Baltimore, the people of Baltimore, you know, to the fullest with love and good food and just customer service just all the way around. And we just appreciate your support. Just be on the lookout for us for anything that we're expanding on. We are hoping to get a brick and mortar soon. That way y'all can come sit down and, you know, and just the full experience of everything. So we just, you guys, thank you so much for welcoming us to this great city from the South and allowing us to feed you like our mamas did us.
Yeah, Creole Soul, spice for your life.
And food for your soul.
Hey now. Folks, and we're on those words, we're out. Love, peace, and happiness.
Bye, y'all.
A lot of businesses revamp extremely quick. Everything from coffee shops, dinner, bars, hotels, we're ready.